Well, hi, hello, my dear students. Welcome to my video lecture class. Right up to now, I uploaded video lectures on the chapter Magnetic Effect of Current. In this chapter, in the last lecture, I discussed about applications of Biot Savart's law. In that, first application completed. So now, we will discuss few numericals based upon the first application. So please observe carefully and few more concepts related with that first application we'll discuss now. So observe carefully. So these are very, very important for the NEET as well as board point of view. My dear student, watch this lecture till the end. Definitely you'll get a clear idea about this concept. So please watch the lecture till the end. So you'll get all concept with crystal clear. Right. So now, based upon first application, let us consider finite length of wire. Finite length of wire means, so this is a case one. So these are the examples of application 1. So in application 1, case 1, finite length of wire. So a finite length means it has some fixed length. Two ends are fixed ends. This is a fixed end and this one is a fixed end. Finite length of wire means. So we need to find magnetic field at this point P. Okay, so let I be the current passing through this one. So what are the steps for finding magnetic field at point P? How to find magnetic field acting at point P due to this current carrying wire? What are the steps? Step 1 is draw an imaginary line. Draw the imaginary line from fixed end to point. This is step 1. What is the step 1 here? Step 1 is draw an imaginary line. So you can note down here. Rules for finding magnetic field. Steps for finding magnetic field. Due to current carrying wire. Finite length or infinite length of wire. So what is the steps? Step one is draw imaginary line from fixed end to point P. Step 2, draw a perpendicular line from straight wire, to point P. Step 3, locate angles pi 1 and pi 2. That angles pi 1 and pi 2 must or in opposite direction. Then only
Bayard-Savart's law is valid. Then only Bayard-Savart's law is valid.
So let us consider finite length of wire. Okay, these are the steps. So here, first locate draw a perpendicular line. First step, step one, draw an imaginary line from a point, from a fixed end to point, from fixed end to point, fixed end to point. Next step two, draw a perpendicular line from straight wire to point, straight wire to point. This is a perpendicular distance. This perpendicular distance is indicated with D. Indicated with D. And angle, step three, locate angles pi 1 and pi 2. Pi 1 and pi 2. So this is some angle. So this is some angle pi 2. This is an angle. This is an angle pi 2. Pi 1. So this is an angle pi 1. Both angles direction is opposite direction. We start from imaginary line and end at perpendicular line. Start from imaginary line, end at perpendicular line. So this pi 1 and pi 2 are perpendicular. At this case, magnetic field at point P formula is mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin pi 1 plus sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. If you apply sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. Sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. Okay. So mu P is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. For example, this pi 2 is given some 60 degrees. If pi 1 is given some 30 degrees, so we'll get, what answer we'll get? Magnetic field at point P is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin 60 degrees plus sin 60 degrees plus sin 30 degrees. So this formula when is valid? For finite length of wire. So this formula is valid. Magnetic field at point P is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin P1 plus sin P2. Sin 60 plus sin 30. Then what we will get here? If mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin 60 value. Sin 60 is root 3 by 2. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. So we will get here mu naught I by 4 pi d into root 3 plus 1 by root 3 plus 1 by 2. Root 3 plus 1 by 2. And direction. Here, how to find magnetic field direction? By using right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule. Ampere's right hand thumb rule. Thumb indicates direction of current. Curling fingers indicates direction of magnetic field. Thumb indicates direction of current. Curling fingers indicates direction of magnetic field. Here, magnetic field is acting into the face. Magnetic field is acting into the face. Observe carefully. Here, magnetic field is acting into the plane. Into the plane. So, because current direction is upward. Current direction is, here current direction is upward. Na? Thumb indicates current direction. Curling fingers here into the face. So, that's why magnetic field at point P is mu naught I by 4 pi d into root 3 plus 1 by 2. And direction is into the face. Into the face or into the plane. So, this is case 1. Next, we will discuss case 2. Case 2 in application 1. Case 2 in application 1. So these steps are important. These steps are common for all the cases. Okay. Case 2. Let us consider infinite length of wire. Infinite length of wire. So infinite length of wire means a long wire. There is no fixed points. There are free ends for infinite length of wire. So for example, this is a wire. So infinite length of wire means it doesn't having a fixed point. This is infinite length of wire. So we need to find magnetic field at this point P. Okay. So I be the current passing through this wire. Okay. What is the first step? How to find magnetic field due to this wire? You know already According to Oersted, every current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. Here I consider infinite length of wire. Some I be the current passing through this wire, and I consider in one point P. This current carrying wire produces magnetic field. That magnetic field is acting on point P. That value we need to find. Magnetic field at point P, we need to find. This value we need to find due to infinite length of wire. So what is step 1? Draw an imaginary line from fixed end to point. Fixed end to point. So these ends, this is finite length of wire. For finite length of wire, fixed ends are there. But for infinite length of wire, we don't have fixed ends. Are you got my point? This is infinite wire. We don't have fixed end. This is a free end. And this one also a free end. Because it is an infinite length of wire. Okay. So here, we have the line from free end. Free ends to point P. How can we draw? Fixed end is there means we can able to draw. Okay. So we can't able to match these two. That's why we will get lines is like this. Parallel lines. And perpendicular line. Okay. Are you understood or not? Here the simple thing. Need not to worry about this. My dear students. Simple logic. What is a step 1 here? Draw a imaginary line from free ends to point. You know, where is this end? We don't know. This end is continuous. This line is continuous. Where it is exist also, we don't know. Then how we can draw a line from this point to this one? So these two lines are never meet. That's why we'll get a parallel line. Okay. So parallel lines we got parallel lines. So they are never meet here. So these are parallel lines. And this is a perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance D. And here the angles we got. This is a theta 1 is equal to or pi 1. Pi 1 or theta 1. Pi 1 is equal to 90 degrees. And here pi 2 is also 90 degrees. Okay. So two ends are free ends. Whenever free end is there, so you can note on that point also, note point also. For free end, pi is equal to 90 degrees. For fixed end, pi value is less than 90 degrees. So these note points also very important. For free end, pi value is 90 degrees. For fixed end, pi value is less than 90 degrees. So that means some angle is there. So this is fixed end, here it is fixed end. Pi 1 is equal to 90 degrees, pi 2 is equal to 90 degrees. So then we will get a magnetic field at point P. Magnetic field at point P is equal to, we got a mu naught I by, general formula is 4 pi d into sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. Then this pi 1 and pi 2 values are 90 degrees. Then we'll get mu naught I by 4 pi d into here 90 plus 90 sin 90 degrees plus sin 90 degrees. Then we'll get mu naught I by 4 pi into sin 90 plus sin 90, 2. 2 how many times? 2 times. Then what we will get? Mu naught I by 4 pi d. Mu naught I by 4 pi d. Sorry. Here 2 times now. So that's why we got here 2. Okay. So magnetic field due to infinite wire, infinite length of wire. Magnetic field due to infinite length of wire formula, mu naught I by 2 pi d. Mu naught I by 2 pi d. This is very, very important. Magnetic field due to finite length of wire is mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. magnetic field due to infinite length of wire mu naught I by 2 pi d. So I will write here node point. So what is a final node point here? Final node point. Magnetic field due to finite length of wire. Current carrying finite length of wire. B is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into sine pi 1 plus sine pi 2. Okay, next. Magnetic field due to current carrying infinite length of wire. B is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d into here pi 1 and pi 2 is 90 degrees. That's why we'll get here mu naught I by 2 pi d. So this is very, very important. Magnetic field due to current carrying infinite length of wire means we should take formula mu naught I by 2 pi d. Magnetic field due to current carrying finite length of wire means mu naught I by 4 pi d into sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. Okay. So here pi 1 less than 90 degrees. Here pi 2 less than 90 degrees. Pi 1 less than 90 degrees. Pi 2 less than 90 degrees. Magnetic field due to current carrying infinite length of wire means pi 1 is equal to 90 degrees. Pi 1 is equal to 90 degrees. Pi 2 is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. So this is about today's session. We will discuss few more details about this further lectures. I hope all of you understood this. Thank you. Thank you so much. All the very best.